Hello everyone. Today we're going to learn how to say to go. Like I go. And we'll learn how to say I went. And future tense of go will go. And I am going. Okay, let's start. First word, go. Which means to go. For example, I go, you go. So we say 가요 in Korean. This is 가 plus 요. 요, it means nothing. 가 means go. 요 is a letter we put after a word to make it politer, make it more polite. So you can just say 가 to your friends or someone who's younger than you. But other than that, you better put 요 after that. Went means 갔어요. So, you is the same. This is 가, which is from here, plus 상시옷어요. Ending consonant and 어요. This is pronounced s, like S, very strong S. So, 갔어요. 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 But when you pronounce it, we don't pronounce 갔어요. We don't. We pronounce 갔어요. There's a reason. 갔어요's. The ending sound, s sound, goes to the next sound, next letter. So this s sound, and there's 잉, which means there's no sound, like zero or nothing. So when a consonant meets 잉, vowel 잉, it goes here. Like you say, what's up? You don't say what's up. You say what's up. Right? It's same. S is connected to the vowel that comes after. So we say 갔어요. Now future tense will go is 갈 거예요. Now you're gonna start to catch up a little bit of routine or rule to make things. This is from 가 plus 리을 ending sound, which goes here, and 거예요. This means will. So, 갈 거예요. 갈 거예요 is will go. 갈 거예요. The last one is be going. I am going, you're going, he's going. That says 가고 있어요. Which is consisted of 가, which is from here, plus 고 있어요. So this is like ing that is attached to a verb. go 있어요. So this means go, ing, going. And when you pronounce 가고 있어요, it's same. When you see 있어요, it when it's separately written, it, you. But when we read it as 갔어요, we read it 있어요. Because, as I told you, s sound goes to 잉 and fills 잉 instead. So, 쌍시옷 goes here. So it's pronounced 있어요. 가고 있어요. 가고 있어요. Okay, let's read it again. Go, 가요, 가요. Went, 갔어요, 갔어요. Will go, 갈 거예요, 갈 거예요. Be going, 가고 있어요, 가고 있어요, 가고 있어요. Okay, let's put this word in a sentence. Let's make sentences. I go. 나는 가요. So 가요 is what you learned, right? I is 나 in Korean. Go is 가요 or 가. So 나는 가요. I go. But you're not familiar with this. 는. 는 is subject marking particle. So this 는 indicates that 나, that this is attached, is a subject. So when you see 는 after a word, that means this is a subject of that sentence. So 나는 가요. 나는 가요. Number two, past tense. I went. Oh, sorry. I went. Same. 나는 I 갔어요. 나는 갔어요. 나는 갔어요. I will go. Nanan 갈 거예요. 나는 갈 거예요. 나는 갈 거예요. 나는 갈 거예요. I am going. Is 나는 가고 있어요. Let's read it. 나는 가고 있어요. 나는 가고 있어요. 나는 가고 있어요. Okay, let's repeat after me. 나는 가요. 나는 갔어요. 나는 갈 거예요. 나는 가고 있어요. Okay, now, I'll read English sentence and you'll read, or if you can do, you just say it without saying it. Okay? I go. 나는 가요. I went. 나는 갔어요. I will go. 나는 갈 거예요. I'm going. 나는 가고 있어요. One more time. I go. 나는 가요. I went. 나는 갔어요. I will go. 나는 갈 거예요. I'm going. 나는 가고 있어요. Okay. Now, I'll mix it. I'll read it randomly. Then you translate it to Korean. Okay? I go. 나는 가요. I will go. 나는 갈 거예요. I went. 나는 갔어요. I'm going. 나는 가고 있어요. I go. 나는 가요. I went. 나는 갔어요. I will go. 나는 갈 거예요. I'm going. 나는 가고 있어요. Okay, let's put one more word, which is home. 나는 가요, which was I go. Home, 집. But we put one more letter after that, which is e. This is kind of like to, when you say go to somewhere. I go to school, I go to work, I go to meet my friends. No, I go to a place. Yeah, so this is like to. So 집에 가요. When you say home, you don't say to, but anyway, this e is used as the meaning of to. I went home. You can do it. 나는 집에 갔어요. 집에 갔어요. I home 갔어요. Went. 나는 집에 갔어요. I will go home. 나는 갈 거예요. Where? To? 집에. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. So when you read 집에, 집에, ending sound is b, b. It goes here. So when you pronounce it, you read it like 집에. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. I'm going home. 나는 가고 있어요. I am going. Where to? 집에. 나는 집에 가고 있어요. 나는 가고 있어요. 나는 집에 가고 있어요. Okay, let's repeat after me. 나는 집에 가요. 나는 집에 가요. I went home. 나는 집에 갔어요. 나는 집에 갔어요. I will go home. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. I'm going home. 나는 집에 가고 있어요. 나는 집에 가고 있어요. 나는 집에 가고 있어요. So when you cover this, you say 나는 가요. 나는 갔어요. 나는 갈 거예요. 나는 가고 있어요. You just add one more word. Okay. Now I'll read in English and you read or say in Korean. I go home. 나는 집에 가요. I went home. 나는 집에 갔어요. I will go home. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. I'm going home. 나는 집에 가고 있어요. Okay, now I will say these sentences in randomly, and you say in Korean. I go home. 나는 집에 가요. I will go home. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. I went home. 나는 집에 갔어요. I'm going home. 나는 집에 가고 있어요. One more time. I will go home. 나는 집에 갈 거예요. I went home. 나는 집에 갔어요. I go home. 나는 집에 가요. I'm going home. 나는 집에 가고 있어요. Okay, this is pretty much everything for this lesson. And if you want to practice more, you can just rewind it, or maybe I'll upload another video just for you to practice repeating after me or translating what I say in English to Korean. Okay, everyone. In next class, we are going to learn how to say walk, walked, will walk. I am walking. Okay, see you guys later. Bye.